So the never-ending saga of getting a pair of pistols, Glock 19s, Gen 3 from Glock, that don't shoot brass at my forehead or the top of my head. Got a set in 2016. They were glossier than this. They've replaced them 2.5 times. I say that because I did not bother trying the ones that they sent me from 2022, the first set, because they had a chalkboard finish. So the solution is, according to them, this Band-Aid solution, right? It's to replace with a later generation ejector. So 336, replace that with 10274 at the time the Gen 4 came out. And then Gen 4s had these issues. So then they started replacing the Gen 4 pistol ejectors with Gen 5. That's 47021. And now I believe they'll pretty much put the Gen 5 ejectors in any gun that's malfunctioned. Two issues I'm concerned about. One is snagging on the back plate during reassembly. And the second one is the stuff I've been reading about pressure. So it is hitting it. You gotta shimmy it a little bit. It's not terrible, but I mean, it's basically new. It's already got marks on it. the second one is, apparently, if you put a loaded round in the magazine, it'll put undue pressure on that round via the ejector, because it's not really how it's supposed to sit. And of course, don't forget all the reports about issues with ejecting the last round, even with nothing supporting it from the magazine. And down below, even for those so-called good pistols. So, first of all, let's see if this works without taking it apart, going through all that trouble. I've read that I should be able to pull this up just enough without undoing these pins to pull the ejector. Looks like that's true. Second thing, I got a pair of pliers here with no teeth. And, people push these from the rear. You really don't have to do that. You know what, maybe you can't cheat from both ends. It might be easier to pull this if it were completely removed from the frame. All right, well, maybe that won't work. See if I can push it from the rear. Nope. All right, I had to do this off camera. Pushing it from the back didn't work. I've done this previously with no trouble, but it's as tight as a son of a bitch. And also, let me note some. Some little bit of flash there that really could have been trimmed up if I had an X-Acto knife handy. So the way I got that out was actually to rock it side to side. Should come out the rest of the way now. And a little comparison. There you got your Gen 3. There's plenty of pictures of this online, but Gen 3, Gen 4, Gen 5, Gen. These are both Gen 5. 3, 4, 5. 4 is interesting. It's twisted. These are just bent. And kind of irritated me is I got 2 of these and the twist is different. So I'm guessing I would get 2 different ejection patterns, because right now these pistols are both equally trash. So let's proceed with installing the Gen 4 ejector. Going in pretty easily. Just pushed it in with my thumb, and I'm just gonna, trying to be really careful not to slip and just gaff. This plastic is soft, and actually, if you have to replace these string, this is kind of the Achilles heel of these Gen 3. You will chew this up trying to pry the end of the spring out. So this back in, putting the pin in. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a mag, one mag for each one, and of course, I've got the second piston here. I mean, they were really accommodating. I said, can I get green ones? Yeah, sure, if we have them. Can I get sequential? Can you pick me out a finish that's not too rough? The problem is not that they're helpful or not helpful. The problem is that they just don't have good pistols that work right. Also, you know, they keep saying that they test the gun. I send it back after I find out it doesn't, and they say, oh, you're right. Yeah, I know I'm right. Oh, you didn't notice before it went out. I know how to grip these, not my first Glocks. Look at this, and that's what you get with these plastic guns. I don't know if this is from them or from me. I doubt it's from me, but they already have nicks, and the plastic is soft. So whatever. So I'm probably not gonna get to trying the five in this. It's hard enough to remove the ejector. I'll probably go shoot the, with the Gen 4. Also, it would be interesting to find out if the ejection pattern is different because they are shaped a little different from each other. But, and so this is the Gen 3 ejector, no interference. And well, I'd say get a closer look. It's pushing it down a little bit, but not with a ton of force. People talk about, oh, what's it gonna do with the pin? It's rocking. Well, it's not really, because it's seated and this is in a slot and the pin's in here, so it's pretty well supported. I don't think it's really a huge deal. So I think I'm gonna leave this off here and talk about the Gen 5s if this doesn't work. And then of course, upcoming video of me shooting these with the Gen 4 ejectors.